Morning, children. Today we are going to learn about the cell structure and its functions. My name is Rajshekar Salkineni, ZPHS Kumugudam, Palvancha. Introduction of the lesson. You see a large variety of animals and plants in your surroundings. They all are various sizes and shapes and also look different to each other. But one thing is common in all of them. They all are made up of a small unit of life, that is cell. Introduction of cell. A cell is the basic structural and functional unit of life. Discovery of the cell. Who discovered the cell first? Children, do you know who is he? Yes, he is Robert Hooke. The cells were first discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665. He examined a thin slice of cork under a primitive microscope and saw little compartments. Robert Hooke called these boxes cells. Types of organisms. There are two types of organisms are there. One is unicellular organisms, another one is multicellular organisms. In unicellular organism, a single cell may consist of a whole organism, for example, amoeba and paramecia. In multicellular organism, many cells group together in a single body and assume different functions in it to form various body parts, for example, animals and plants. Each of living cells has the capacity to perform certain basic functions that are characteristics of all living forms. For example, the cells of heart to pump the blood, the cells of stomach to digest the food. The cell contains certain specific components within it known as cell organelles. Shapes and sizes of cells. The size of certain living organisms may be as small as millionth of meter or may be as large as few centimeters. The smallest cell is 0.1 to 0.5 micrometers in bacteria. The largest cell measuring 170 millimeters into 130 millimeters is the egg of an ostrich. Plasma membrane and its functions. This is the outermost covering of the cell that separates the content of the cell from its external environment. It also prevents movement of some other materials. So, cell membrane therefore is called as selectively permeable membrane. Cell wall and its functions. The cell wall has another rigid outer covering of the plant. That lies plasma membrane. The cell wall is mainly composed of cellulose. Cellulose is a complex substance that provides structural strength to the plants. Functions of cell wall. Cell wall provides the rigidity and strength to the cell. Cytoplasm and its functions. The cytoplasm is the fluid content inside the plasma membrane. It also contains many specified cell organelles. Each of these organelles performs a specific functions for the cell. Functions of cytoplasm. In cytoplasm, all cell organelles are abundant. Nucleus and its functions. The nucleus has a double layer covering called nucleus membrane. Nucleus membrane has pores which allow the transfer of materials from inside the nucleus to its outside, that is to the cytoplasm. The nucleus contains chromosomes. Chromosomes contains information for inheritance of features from parents to next generation in the form of DNA. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid. In some organisms like bacteria, the nuclear membrane region of the cell may be poorly defined due to the absence of nuclear membrane. These organisms are known as prokaryotes. Organisms which cell have a nuclear membrane are called eukaryotes. Functions of nucleus. The nucleus plays a central role in cellular reproduction. The process by which a single cell divides and forms two new cells. It also regulates the cellular activities. Vacuole. Vacuole are storage sac for solid or liquid content in animal cells. The size of vacuole is small, while plant cells have very large vacuoles. The central vacuole of some plant cells may occupy 50 to 90% of the cell volume. Plastids. Plastids are present only in plant cell, not in animal cell. Plastids are similar to mitochondria in external structure. Types of plastids. There are two types of plastids are there. One is chromoplast, another one is leucoplast. Chromoplast are colorless plastids which provides different colors to the flowers and fruits. Leucoplasts are colorless plastids. They store some material like starch, oils and protein granules. Chlorophyll containing plastids are known as chloroplasts. They are important for photosynthesis in plants. Difference between plant and animal cells. Summary. Let us summarize what we have learned. In 1665, Robert Hooke discovered a cell first. On the basis of presence of single or many cells, the organisms are two types, unicellular and multicellular organisms. Each cell contains specific components within it known as cell organelles that perform a specific function. Plastids are present only in plant cell, not in animal cells. Plant cells have another rigid outer covering called the cell wall that lies outside the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane also works as selective permeable membrane by allowing the entry and exit of some materials. Vacuoles are storage sac for solid or liquid contents. In animal cells, the size of vacuoles is small, while plant cells have very large vacuoles. Nucleus is a spherical or oval dot-like structure present near to center of the each cell. It plays a central role in cellular reproduction and its regulate cell activities. Thank you one and all. Thank you.